Hello, this is Kurt Worley, FX strategist and trader coach at FXBootcamp.com. Today is Thursday, December 20th, 2012. As I speak, it is about 40 minutes after 10 a.m. New York time. We're in the second half of the New York morning trading session. I'm looking at a one-hour chart for the Euro-USD currency pair on the Owanda MT4 trading platform. And I want to bring your attention to a trading range we appear to be in the midst of right now on this major currency pair. Look on mostly on the upper right hand portion of this chart, you see the high established in the early part of Monday's Asian session there. Some late London session highs established on Tuesday here. Those highs in the 3185 to 3190 area, that 5 pip range represented by two horizontal blue lines in the middle of this chart. The topmost blue line is at 3190. You can see how that area provided support for
Moody's
the euro.
He's commenting on potential fiscal cliff, saying that a fiscal cliff zone recession would weaken most U.S. securitizations.
I talked about this in yesterday's Trader Alert video. I talked about the 3280 area and how important that has been over the past several months, and actually almost years. It's been like more than 5 years that the 3280 area on occasion, on multiple occasions, has affected price action on this pair. Now, we did top out just north of 133 yesterday, during yesterday's New York morning session. You can see the test of 133 there yesterday. Earlier in today's New York morning session, we approached 133, failed to match that level. So you've got a resistance zone between, say, 132.80 and 133. And at the moment, we're in the middle of this trading zone. Again, support around 31.85, 31.90. Resistance around 32.80, 133 area. Worth noting, though, we're in an area right now as I speak. That's called the 3235 to 3240 area, which does seem to have affected price action in the recent past. Notice some highs and lows I'm highlighting now. Including this one, and more recently we're stalled just as I speak around 3235 at the moment. So looking forward to the rest of the New York morning session, what could we look at? Well, a little more of the same. Could be a little bit of ping pong here. The euro might stall out a bit as the market awaits U.S. House Speaker Boehner's press conference due to begin at 1:15 p.m. New York time. That's about 2.5 hours from now. Again, U.S. House Speaker Boehner, the main representative for the Republican Party in the fiscal cliff negotiations between Republicans and the Democratic White House, specifically President Obama. Boehner due to deliver a press conference at 1:15 p.m. New York time after today's European market close, after today's London close. So the market may stall a bit and wait for that. But let's talk about the shape of price action from here. And potentially for those seeking a trade before the end of this New York morning session, a trade that you might hold beyond London close, you know, what that might look like. So I'm going to go to a shorter term time frame, namely a 15-minute chart. Here's a 15-minute chart for the Euro-USD. Again, this shows price action going back to, looks like early part of yesterday's trading. You can see yesterday's highs on the upper left-hand of the portion of the chart. Again, yesterday's highs really close to 133. Here's one plausible scenario for the Euro moving forward here. Let me get the drawing tool going here. And the trade I'm about to describe here is one you would take, especially if you're betting on expressions of concern about fiscal cliff negotiations from U.S. House Speaker Boehner. If Boehner expressed concerns about the fiscal cliff debt talks, then we could see some dollar strength in response to that. Dollar strength obviously means down for this pair. So if you're looking to bet on Boehner's expressing concerns about fiscal cliff talks, which should rally the dollar during the New York afternoon following his comments at his press conference beginning again at 1:15 p.m. New York time, then you'd like to look for euro short, if you're willing to hold on to that trade through the Boehner comments and the Boehner press conference. So here's the idea. You see a rise here in the euro, bigger rise there. What I'm suspecting is that we may have some sort of a crown or head and shoulders reversal pattern with a neckline somewhere in the 3235 area. Now, I'm specifically looking at the 3265 area. Notice yesterday, in the upper left-hand portion of the chart, you can see yesterday the euro found temporary support around 3265. You see a swing high there. And I'm back on the right-hand side of the chart. Let me recast the drawing tool here. You have a high here around 32.65 and some recent lows there. So what I'm envisioning, if we the euro does eventually find support here around 32.35, is a rise back up to about 60 or 65 zone. That could be a potential short. And a short, you hope you get back to at least 32.35 at around the start of the Boehner press conference. And again, if U.S. House Speaker Boehner expresses more concerns about the U.S. fiscal cliff negotiations, that could benefit the dollar. That could weigh on the euro. And a target for that trade, with entries somewhere around 32.65, that support zone we mentioned earlier, around 31.85, 31.90.